So it is a probiotic, so very similar to the type of probiotics that people might take for gut health, except that it's a bacteria that's been engineered to help consume phenylalanine for the PKU patient. So the bacteria itself eats extra phenylalanine. So the idea would be is they take it with meals and it would consume not all, but some of the phenylalanine that is in the food that the patient takes. So they would take it again with each meal and the bacteria would eat some of the phe before it gets absorbed in the intestine. What's been done has been mostly what we call open label. So there's been no placebo trial done so far. There's just been a study of the bacteria in people who don't have PKU to make sure it's safe, which it was. And then subsequently in people with PKU for short periods of time to see how much phe lowering can occur. And in the most recent trial, on average, when people took this for a short period of time, it was able to lower the blood phenylalanine. And, you know, there was a big range, but on average, about 30% reduction in the blood phe. So again, not really a complete cure, but that could lead to being able to increase the amount of protein in the diet and help just increase the amount of dietary protein that somebody could eat and allow the bacteria to do some of it. So that the next trial, which is really the pivotal, what we call phase 3 trial, that needs to have some period of time where there's a placebo controlled time point or arm. So the way this trial is designed is that the participants will be started on the probiotic, and there are several sort of escalating doses available. So they'll start at a certain dose, and then if they tolerate that over a few weeks, they'll go up to the next dose and go up to a maximum dose if they're able to tolerate those. And the tolerance is really about do they have any stomach upset at all with any of the probiotics? And they basically go to the dose that they can tolerate, and we'll be monitoring their blood phenylalanines and their diet, obviously, through that whole thing, not changing their diet, keeping that the same. And then once they get to a dose that they're tolerating, then the second phase will be a randomized discontinuation phase. So I won't know as an investigator, and the company won't know. The people will be chosen randomly to either continue on the probiotic or to be switched to a placebo for a period of time, and we'll keep checking their blood phenylalanine levels, but we and the participants won't see those numbers. And obviously the goal will be to see that the persons who stay on the probiotic, their phe levels will stay down presumably, and those on placebo, the levels would go back up. And then that would prove, of course, that the probiotic is actually having the effect that it's meant to do, which is to keep the blood phes under control. And so that goes through a period of weeks. And then at the end of that period of time, the patients go back on, everybody goes back on on open label drug. Everybody goes back onto the probiotic, and they can continue on that in what's called the open label extension and continue to be treated.